No, I'm not showing you any hidden symbol or anything. I am turning on my sunglasses there. Sunglasses which also needed an update, because these are the Schülbo Evad 1, where actually at my right eye here, I have a heads-up display. Getting data now just from the smartphone Active Look app, but well, developing somewhere, at least hopefully, to work at the very least with Garmin in a very nice way. For now, they are not yet there, but supposedly coming. Let me tell you a bit more in peace and quiet. Here we are with the box. So, works without the smartphone with a compatible watch, which is only a Garmin, which is one big reason I've switched to the Forerunner 945 for a bit. It works also with the app. I hope sooner or later it's going to work with the Wear OS system, maybe. Suunto probably can't do it. But, well, we'll see. Mm-hmm. Yes, and there we are. Pretty nice hard case. Mm-hmm. Bag. Tips for cleaning. Loops for holding them. Cleaning cloth. And what you don't usually have with your sunglasses, a USB, micro USB cord. Biggest interest, of course, are the glasses. And they are, yeah, a bit top heavy, of course. There is a bit of hardware in there, but it's not outrageous. A bit of the, well, battery, I think, is what is here, is noticeable, but so you can see a little something being there towards your nose. But it's all not horrible at all. It's quite funny because something feels like it's there already, although of course I don't have them turned on yet. So... Mm-hmm. So there are the usual explanations here to see them, to charge them, to adjust them to your face. Yes, true. I could want to do that. To download the Active Look app, to switch on and pair, and all of that. Yeah. I have to admit, I do have to be a bit careful. I need to shift it up a bit there to get more of an angle, to actually be able to see all of the data on the screen. But that data visible is seen really crisply, and the glasses, the lenses are photochromic. For the display there is a light sensor, so this adjusts to how bright or dark it is. And even when the sun was just shining directly towards me, the HUD still remained visible. Now there's little light and it's visible. I have been running before in the dark at night, and it remained visible and not so bright that it disturbed too much. So this is very nice, with a bit of a caveat of having to shift the glasses up a bit, at least for me. But of course they are also made for cycling, so more for a different kind of position. But this is, well, a mixed bag as everything on the EVAD 1 right now, but quite nice. Why all this talk about the mixed bag? Well, right now the state is still the one it has been for a month already, which is that the Shulbo EVAD 1 is mainly usable with a Garmin watch. There is a Connect IQ app for it, but it's only usable with this Connect IQ app, meaning you cannot just start a normal sports mode on your Garmin and have this recorded and see all the data you get from that. You can only, if you want to see data in your heads-up display, start something running the Connect, the Connect IQ Active Look app, see the data which is there, switch through that data on your watch and see it reflected in the heads-up display. I'm not even entirely sure if this gets sensibly recorded when you just started there. I'm pretty sure it did, but this was not so much fun. My contact at Shulbo said that there should be an update which will make it possible to use the EVAD 1 as, I'm guessing, an extended display, so that all the data shown in a normal sports mode on a Garmin watch will be reflected in the heads-up display. This should even come with something, at least, of the map display being reflected in the heads-up display. But, well, actually I need to change the tense I'm talking in, because this should have already come, and it certainly is not yet there. There's still only the Connect IQ app, not more. When or if this comes, it would be pretty interesting. The data is beautifully visible. I do like having it literally in front of my one, at least I, sometimes. But yeah, it's still a bit missing like that. And there is no word even about an Apple Watch app or a Wear OS app for Active Look for the EVAD 1 glasses, which would be, well, a bit difficult maybe in terms of battery life and all of this, but still, for the high-tech stuff that this all is, it would be pretty cool, but no word of it. It does not look like it. An extended display for Suunto, for Coros, for Polar sounds even more unlikely, so this all is not really sounding too good. Garmin coming at least, yeah, then this would be a whole different game. So far for a really sensible use of data of the Shulbo EVAD 1, we are still stuck with the Active Look app on the smartphone. This connects pretty well. It makes it possible to use the gesture sensor to go through the different screens. That is nice. But after every update of the app so far, I've had to turn back on the gesture sensor and the automatic light brightness sensor brightness switching, which I often enough overlooked, and then I was very annoyed when I could not just change it with going over the frame like that. So, okay, in the app what you of course need to consider is that you need to know to turn on the location use for it for always, or you get some problems with the distance. Using the smartphone app you get even the current time and the battery, the charge level of the glasses displayed, which is nice, but is the thing I only get to see if I have the glasses up quite a bit at a level. Somehow for me this does not work differently. It might be because of my eyes, because of the contact lenses, but that's how it is, and it's a bit off, a bit, yeah, less than ideal. You do get quite a bit of data of distance, of pace, of essence. A lot. Heart rate is the one thing which even works with an external sensor. I'm not even sure how I got that. It was too easy. I don't know. I bought a Polar H10 heart rate belt. I had it found by my phone anyway, so I tapped on the heart rate, it was there. This has been working very nicely, okay. But there's still no customization of the data you get displayed in the app. The app has been developing a bit, but how you notice it is typically that, like I said, you have to turn back on the ambient light adjustment of the HUD brightness, you have to turn back on the gesture sensor, and otherwise you notice it because you want to go out, and you finally turn everything back on. You hopefully had the sunglasses charged recently enough so they still hold a charge and aren't empty. That has happened to me too. And then you connect it to the app, and then you have the app tell you there is a new update, which you must do now, and before you have not done that, you can't really connect anything, use anything anymore, so you need to wait for that. You are not shown actually anywhere what this update was for, what it did. There are no changes I've ever seen anywhere in terms of functionality, like me waiting for the Garmin support to be improved. So it's a very mixed bag. It is very high tech, very nice. It's quite a lot of fun sometimes to be able to see the time, the distance, the pace, the ascent just there in the glasses. But then again, even just with the connection to the app, battery life is not so good. I swipe through it and then there's one screen, one set of screens in the app, and so on the display, and a second, and a third, and then the next one turns the display off, and you need to go over it again to turn it back on again. And so there are many of those little niggles, and for something which is expensive as those glasses are, yeah, I really hope that in the new year they are going to improve quite a bit, if even just the Garmin support were to make it just an extended display. This would be pretty nice, pretty interesting, but first we need to get there and we need to see if we will ever get there. So it's a good thing those glasses are finally not vaporware anymore. They are, or at least they have been, available since October off and on again. That's fine, that's how I got them, but yeah, now we need to really see some improvements happening there. And Jules Beau has not been the best in saying what is coming or what has come in updates even, let alone where things are going to develop. So we'll have to just wait and see and hope. And yeah, hoping for improvements on something pretty expensive, not ideal. I'm hopeful, at least my geek side is hopeful and wants to hope for something, but yeah, Let's see.